is example number 5. Draw the orthographic projections of the given figure. So, orthographic projections. So, again, we have to draw the three views, front view, top view, and side view. And the arrow, as the arrow is here, this means this is going to be our front view, and this is going to be our left hand side view, and this is going to be our top view. And you need to observe that in the top view, there is one hole. Because of this hole only, I have taken this question. Because this will explain many things related to orthographic projections. There is a concept of hidden lines. There is a concept of drawing the hollow portion. It can be easily understood from this example. So, please observe. So, here, as I have said, the circle is very important, and the diameter of this also is also given. So, when we talk about views, it's very simple that you are seeing this rectangle in the front view and this rectangle in the left hand side view, and the top view will have also one rectangle with a circle placed at this position. But here in the front view, you will have some hidden lines here from this, because of this circle being there, because of this hollow portion being at the center of this object. So we'll see its explanation. Like first we will see the front view, top view, and side view. So this red color portion will appear in the front view, and in the top view I'm going to paint this with green color, but excluding this hole, because there is a hole, and this blue color portion will appear in the left hand side view. So you need to be careful about this hole which is not visible, and due to this hole only you will get some hidden lines in the front view and in the left hand side view. So now we will see how to draw this in the drawing sheet.
First, draw the front view of this figure, which is going to be a simple rectangle again. So this is 70 and this height is 40 mm. The height is 40. So again, first I will complete this rectangle, and it seems that the front view is completed, but there is something about this hole, as I have mentioned, is missing, which will be the hidden lines. We will draw this, but before that we will complete the top view first. I will tell you the reason in a little while. This here is your XY plane, and now I am starting the top view. Again, this is also a rectangle, and the width of the rectangle is 50. So I am taking this 50 directly from here. Observe that I am drawing this with again H pencil. Now for drawing this circle, we need to get first axis line first in the center, which can be get by drawing the x axis and y axis line in the center. The half of 70 is 35, so half of 50 is 25. So observe that I have taken 25 distance here, and I am drawing this line here to get the center of this circle, and here like 35 from this side, 35. So as you can see, I have already got the center. Now I will draw the circle. The circle diameter is given as 30 mm above, which means that I have to take the radius as 15 mm. Here I am measuring this distance as 15 mm. You can see that 15 mm radius. Completed. Now when coming back to our front view, I have said earlier that there will be dotted lines because of this hole. So the distance of that hole we can get by projecting this line again upwards. So like you have to see here that I am first matching with the axis line, then I am projecting it from the center. again. So I'll just need to, I will just need draw this. These are also called dashed lines. Now our front view and top view is completed. Now I will draw the left hand side view, which will be drawn on the right hand side. For that I need to draw the meter line. At 45 degrees. I have to project this. Yes. Well, one thing here you have to observe that we have to project lines from the hole also in the side view. That means I have to project lines from the corner of this circular hole. As you can see here, these two lines have been projected from the this circle, and I will project them over again. Okay. So these lines are enough for getting the left hand side view. We need not measure anything. We have to just darken this portion over here. A nice little side view is generated. Again, there will be hidden lines. Why? The same reason, when we are seeing from the left hand side, we are getting only one rectangular shape, but there is a circular hole behind this. That is why we are getting this hidden lines. Now I will dimension this figure. There are very few dimensions in this. This is 70. And this height is 40. And the width of this figure is 50. So only now we have to dimension the circular hole. We can either give the radius, or and now here I am giving the diameter of this figure. As we have already known from the review section how to dimension the circular portion, here I am mentioning the diameter symbol. So everything is completed now. We have done the example problem number 5.